So here you are going to watch barbed suspension bridge pharyngoplasty by Vikas Agrawal's technique in a male who's 29 year old. Body mass index is only 25 and apnea hypopnea index is only 19, but still he has got choking episodes. He has got a nose surgery done earlier elsewhere, which has not worked. And on the dice, he has got a collapse at the soft palate level and at the epiglottis level. I have done the tonsillectomy on the right side. He has got a high palatal collapse. And as you can see here, this is the hard palate. And the distance behind the hard palate is not great. And his soft palate is pretty long. So see, you can see my finger is going and touching at this point. But this point is always above the line joining the anterior pillar to anterior pillar. So anterior pillar is here. But if you see, this is the anterior pillar. This is the anterior pillar. Anterior pillar is actually here. This is the posterior pillar. So the base of the uvula is low, but the anterior pillar is here. So the line joining anterior pillar to anterior pillar is your key. And here in this case, you can see this is the extra length of the soft palate, which we need to remove because this is the cause of his obstructive sleep apnea. Therefore, we cannot take a particular length in measurement when we decide to decide how much of tissues are to be removed. His anterior pillar is actually coming till here. So we know that the levator palatine muscle will be here. And as long as we make our limit at anterior pillar to anterior pillar, we are still not going to damage. So I am resecting this long soft palate along the line joining anterior pillar to anterior pillar. So we know that we'll still leave behind a sufficient length of the soft palate. And they're all vertical muscles seen here. There's no horizontal muscle. Horizontal muscle will be of the levator palati. So we are not seeing any horizontal muscle. They're all vertical muscle. This is the musculus uvuli. And you can see how much of the musculus uvuli we are actually. You can see the contraction of the musculus uvuli and the uvula. And right besides the musculus uvuli, this is the posterior pillar or the palatopharyngeus. So this is the horizontal muscle seeing here. We are not going to get into the horizontal muscle. We are only going to cut through the vertical muscle, which is the musculus uvuli. So now we still know that we have sufficient length of the soft palate left behind. Now that's the length of the soft palate left behind, which will prevent alveolopharyngeal insufficiency. Now, at this point of time, let me remove this part of the soft palate along with the uvula. So, this patient's problem is the structure. Now, so that's the length of the soft palate still remaining to prevent a velopharyngeal insufficiency. Now, this is the posterior pillar, the palatopharyngeus, which I'm going to take laterally. But before that, let me remove. These are the fibers of the palatopharyngeus. Let me remove the uvula at this point of time. and you can already see how much of space is created. Now, what is most important, that this posterior pillar or the palatopharyngeus forms the anterior wall of the pharynx. So, this anterior wall will be transposed to the lateral wall. So, I am incising this palatopharyngeus. Till I reach the lateral pharyngeal wall. Now I'm going to transpose it laterally by barbed suture. So now this whole thing will be transposed laterally by the barbed suture. So, the barbed suture I am going to use is VLOC 3O from Covidian. That's the barbed suture. Okay. And I am going to suture it over the pterygomandibular raphe. Now, pterygomandibular raphe, I will just show you the structure. This is the pterygomandibular raphe. This is the mandible, that's the pterygoid tubercle. So, that's the pterygomandibular raphe. Now, you see pterygomandibular raphe is lateral to the pharynx and is anterior to the soft palate. Anterior in various configurations depending on the anatomy, but it is always anterior to the soft palate. So, it will pull it laterally and then I'll go across the midline along the soft palate from one pterygomandibular raphe to the other pterygomandibular raphe. So that is the difference in my technique from the other techniques that are available, that when you go across from one pterygomandibular raphe to the other, it forms a suspension bridge and will not let the soft palate fall. And the lateral arm is the standard that is used in every other technique. So it will take care of both lateral as well as anteroposterior collapse. Now, tongue depressor. Use a tongue depressor and retract it. Thank you. And don't move. Be in one place. Now, I'll be using the barbed suture so that once I take my stitch, I do not have to tie knots. So, that's the pterygomandibular raphe. We go from pterygomandibular raphe, come into the upper part of the tonsil. Fossa. The tonsillectomy has already been done and we'll take the bulk of palatopharyngeus muscle. We'll not get into the mucosa, will remain submucosally. This action will pull the thing laterally. Now we'll take the whole bulk of the palatopharyngeus muscle, trying to expose the barbed suture minimally, and we'll take the whole bulk of palatopharyngeus muscle, as you can see here. Then coming back, through the fibers at the upper pole. If required, we can also take sutures along the lateral pharyngeal wall, but in this case, we know that it's not really required. Now see, what is important, this area may be raw, but the area here, the bottleneck area, is there is no raw area. The whole mucosa is preserved in that area. And from there, can you pull? Correct. Thanks. and from there we'll come back to our area of pterygomandibular that way. We come out of the pterygomandibular raphe and hold the needle over there and take it out. So this forms the lateral leg of our surgery. Now if these fibers are extra, I'll possibly remove them, but you can see that there is no raw area at the junctional area. So this pulls the soft palate laterally. Can you give me the coblation? I'll just remove that extra part of the muscle. This extra part is not really required. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It will okay. Now we go for the anterior leg. So the anterior leg will be from one pterygomandibular raphe to the other pterygomandibular raphe. So we again start from the same point and come till the pre-margin of the soft palate. Obviously, will remain submucosal. Then again, entry from the same point and will cross the midline, go to the other side. Now, what this will do, this will form a suspension bridge between the two sides. Now, from here, I'll go to the other side. Again, entry from the same point so that your suture is not exposed. Thank you. Yeah. Again, entry from the same point and let me go through the same point and come out beyond the pterygomandibular raphe. Can you see that? Let me centralize. Is it seen? So that's the suspension bridge, which will help the soft palate. Now you see one pterygomandibular raphe to the other pterygomandibular raphe. This is suspension bridge. So this soft palate now cannot collapse, it cannot go behind. It can still go up because it has to go up while swallowing. The action of the levator palati is above this. The levator palati will work here. The levator palati can still work, but this palate cannot collapse. The extra part of the soft palate I have already removed. The anterior pillar, the anterior wall of the pharynx has been transposed laterally, and this is the anterior leg. Now I'll take a break. I'll do the tonsillectomy on the left side and then come back to you. So thank you for watching this part 1.